Hey guys and girls, welcome to this video. It have been 9 days since I made my last video and a lot have happened. It's my day number 29 today in my art adventure. And yesterday I got a pleasant news. I sold my first painting. And actually, I didn't promote any paintings yet for sale. I didn't make my homepage yet. I didn't price any paintings yet. Only in my head.
$1 million.
So yeah. It was my friend Ricky. He have taken some pictures of my paintings and he showed to his big brother. And he offered me to buy this one here. I have showed before. But he offered me to buy this painting for $150.
$150?
That's actually 95% discount. Take a chill pill, man. And I accepted because then I had sold my first painting within a month. So that's kind of, I'm pretty happy. I know I'm very happy about that. Another thing I want to talk about in this video is my Instagram. Instagram has been showing. I never really used Instagram before. Like back in 2016, I created my account and I did it and I used it a little bit for my marketing, but only for maybe 1 month, and then I just let it be my account and I never used it. I had around, I followed 1,500 people and the same amount followed me. When I posted my first painting, I got like 4 likes, 5 likes. Then I started to delete people, the people I followed, because the people I followed before was people in the online marketing industry, and I want to make this account for art. That reminds me about another thing I have to talk about. but then I defollowed a lot of people and I start to follow a lot of new people. But the thing is, I go and find in Instagram. See now. Wait, I'll show you in Instagram. Dun, dun, dun. Maybe I'll just put a screenshot. It's better. But in Instagram, I find people which have been, I find paintings, I find another person's painting and I see how many likes the painting have and I go and see who liked that painting. I then go and follow the person who liked the other painting, because if that person seems to like one guy's painting, he probably will also like another guy's painting. If you like my paintings, of course. So I try to find some kind of the same abstract style, like I'm trying to paint. I follow these people and then they start to follow me back. So right now, I have made like, I follow around 1,000 people and now around 1,900 follow me. So I have increased my followers with 400 a person, and now this new 400 people, they are in the art, they like to look at paintings. So that result in, now when I post a painting, I get around 50 likes. And that has only been like I have been using Instagram now maybe 14 days since I reopened my Instagram account. So, but I'm not sure if I can sell anything, but I get some awareness, and that's pretty good. So Instagram, I think it's a nice way to showcase the paintings. Another thing, I'll just wait. So this is my personal Facebook page, and I have been using this since 2008, and I have I had 4,800 friends, and I had 1,900 followers on this account here. And the people who followed me was people who was interested in online marketing. Facebook called this profile my personal profile. Then I went and created a Facebook page for myself, and this looked like this. I have the same cover photo. And then Facebook somehow, they took all of my friends and all of my followers and also made them followers and turned them into likes on my page. And that actually doesn't make any sense for me, because people who like online marketing probably maybe not like art. So why Facebook turned them into like... I lost them. You see, now I only have, I don't know why it's only 1,400 of my followers. Oh, where are we? Now I have 400 followers. Before I have 1,900 followers. So Facebook, for me, it's some kind of little bit annoying. But in the other way, it's make this profile look more pro, because now I have more than 5,000 likes and 5,000 followers on my business profile. And it's nice with this profile here, because you can see exactly how many people have seen your post, and it's like more detailed compared to a personal Facebook page. So yeah, Facebook and Instagram is two platforms I think I'm gonna showcase myself. I will not sell anything from here. The selling will... What I have learned in my 10 years from selling is... It's always better to let the customers come to you than you try to hunt the customers down. So by that, you see, I got my first sale within the first month. From the painting you see here on my back, on this one. I'm a little bit sad I'm gonna sell it, but anyway, it's nice, because the money I get from this painting will make it possible for me to create 8-10 of the same kind of quality painting. See, the canvas is maybe 8-10 canvas for the same. So yeah, I'm ready for my month number 2, and I think it's going in the right direction. I think I have found my style. Like you say, like the first 2 weeks I did learn to work with the oil colors, and now I think I more understand the oil colors. I understand how it's really, really powerful to let the painting dry and then continue to work on it. I don't know if you can see the one in the top. Oh, now I'm seeing this one. This one here. You know what? I'm gonna put a painting when I edit the video. But it's fun. It's fun to continue painting on something you thought actually was done, and then you just keep doing it. I'm sorry. So yeah, that will means I have to say goodbye now, and Facebook, Instagram, my first sale, That was what I want to cover in this video. And creating a Facebook page can be kind of tricky. That's also a point to remember, I would say. I don't know if I had understand the choice, if I would make the people, because right now I don't do any online marketing, I only do this one here. So would it have, I'm not sure if I'm so angry on Facebook by doing this one. Guys, have a nice day. I will go and find my bed. You know, when I'm painting too long in the night. I paint to 2 o'clock in the night or 3 o'clock in the night. So yeah. Guys, have a nice day and I will see you in the next video.